Don't you hate it when you smash up your brand new quad? I was doing a power loop and hit the ground and this thing completely came apart. Broken arm, the whole nine. So I made a freestyle out of it. Hey, welcome back to my channel and appreciate your time. I apologize. I wanted to give you a fair review of the Diatone ER349. I am unable to give you that fair assumption of it other than the memory that I have of the thing. I did a power loop right into the ground. I actually went into the ground backwards. So I was backwards into the ground and it absolutely disassembled itself. It was not pretty. So I've turned it into a 3-inch freestyle. So I don't have a 3-inch race drone anymore. Which is fine. I'm still debating about the whole race drone thing. And this is my new setup, the Martian 4. I did a video on this one. And this is with the 1206 motors. And I already did a full build video on this one. This one is just the ER, the Eachine Diatone Mix ER349. On the frame. I really like this frame. You can fit everything that you need to fit in it. Here you can see the space in there for the camera tilt. I mean, you can tilt the camera back quite a bit. There's only one modification you have to do to this frame. That hole right there is the original hole. And then I had to put a hole in front of it. And that's because of the wire harness for the ESC. But you can see everything fits in there real nice. I mean, it's a good size frame. The camera, you see there's plenty of space. You can put underneath the camera, you can run your receiver right underneath the camera. You can slide a chopstick underneath that camera. So even with a little more up tilt, it might be kind of hard to see with the camera, but you can see my up tilt's not extreme. I like a little more smooth flight, so I'm just I don't know what that would be, maybe 30-35 degrees. But this thing absolutely is a ball. I mean, it absolutely rips. This thing flings over trees. I wouldn't put these side by side, in a competition, but this thing really does act more like a 5-inch than my other 3-inch. That other 3-inch with the 1206 motors is a lot quieter. It doesn't get as much attention. But this one here is quite a ripper. Unfortunately, I ripped the connector off of the TBS Unify, so I had to solder the wires directly to the board. Fortunately, it didn't rip all the pads and everything out. The capacitor is gone, and I chipped my 5-volt regulator, but it still works. This VTX gets extremely hot, even when it was brand new. This VTX, like, you could smell the heat coming off of it when you're working on the bench for only a couple minutes. The video quality, the range seems to be about as good as the AKK Ultimate, the FX3 Ultimate, I think is what it, but it gets way hotter. And then I ran the beeper right in the back. I just kind of, I don't know if you can see the beeper right there. This is the beeper they supplied with the I just stuck it on the back of the frame there, so there's plenty of room for other stuff if you want. Let me see here. We have just strain relief on the battery lead, so when it's plugged in, everything's up out of the way. The other thing I'm going to mention is that this run cam, this is the Swift 2 run cam. I have this camera in my 5-inch race drone, the Swift 2. But for some reason, this camera, this has got the 2.1 lens on it. This camera is so sweet. This camera is my most favorite camera out of all of my cameras. I really like that camera. I've got the Fat Shark HDOs, and that camera is really nice. I like it a lot. I ran my VTX antenna. There really wasn't a whole lot of modification that I did. I literally just kind of stuck the guts into this frame and went and flew it because I was so aggravated that I destroyed that frame. So I wouldn't say easy. It took a pretty good hit, but the screws that they use to hold the back of the frame, the original frame, the screws are like M2 or M1.5. They're really, really small. I mean, they're essentially these screws. I actually bent the screws on the stack when I crashed, so it wasn't a light crash, but it just absolutely destroyed that frame, broke the arm off, crushed the frame. So anyway, this whole thing went right into this frame without any issue. I didn't have to trim the wires. I didn't have to re-solder motor wires or nothing. It laid right in there. And I think the only modification I had to do with this whole thing was I'm not a big fan of the way I have my receiver in here. See if I can get a... See where I have my receiver just kind of adhered to that standoff right there. I've just kind of got that, you can see the ball of goo that I've stuck in there to hold that receiver. I'm not a huge fan of that, but I didn't want to have to re-solder it. And I mean, I can just add more wire here and drop it in under the camera, but it stuck in there pretty good. The other thing I could do is just kind of adhere it up on top here, but honestly, that VTX, you're not really going to stick anything to that VTX. You could cook eggs on that thing. So we have the battery just about like that. And of course, we wrap this up. Don't let me forget to take that off, because that's how I know that that's a flown pack that needs charged. Right now it's on storage because it's raining still. So what I've done essentially is I've put this antenna up front, and I think I might be doing more of that. I think I'm kind of done with the VTX antenna coming out of the back, because as I fly away from myself, I start to lose my video, and sometimes it rapidly goes away, and I turn around and to come back to myself and immediately get my video back. So I'm kind of liking the, should have done that a long time ago, maybe. But this antenna, in a crash, it's not really going to go anywhere. So I'm kind of liking that idea anyway. At first I thought, I don't have an antenna to, I run MMCX on everything. And this is a UFL connector. And you can see there's really not much wire to run. I mean, it's really short. It's like right there to there on the original diatone frame. And I wanted to run it out of the back. But this is actually working out really good. I do fly out a little ways, and if I lose my video, of course it's going through the battery, so you could argue the point, well, it's got to go through the battery, that's why you're losing your video. But I don't know, I'm going farther than I want to go. I mean, it's still within line of sight, of course. So anyway, that is that. So if you want to get this frame for your diatone and turn it into a freestyle, this thing is gnarly. I will try my best to get some flight footage of this. This weekend I'm going to a night race up in Delaware, so should be able to get some flight footage of it. any questions on this, let me know, and I will try to do my best to answer it. 3052, in case you're wondering. So just shoot me a comment, and I'll try to answer any question I can. I appreciate your time. Thanks.